Oh, thank you for those very kind words. The Donald Johnson Eye Care Institute at the Toronto Western Hospital is the biggest and the best eye care center in the country. The staff are internationally renowned for their clinical and basic science research. And the department on the sixth and the seventh floors at the Toronto Western are very busy, as many of you may know. We see and have over 85,000 patient visits per year. One of the visitors is our guest tonight, and his name is Stealth Ng. Now, Stealth is a remarkable young man and an inspiration to both physicians and patients alike. Why? Because he's had 16 eye operations. He's used his fear of blindness to channel his talents into music. He plays violin and piano, and is founder and first violinist for the Grigori String Quartet and the well-known Sipe Piano Quintet. He's an experienced concertmaster, playing both as an accompanist and solo artist. He's an accompanist to the Canadian National Ballet School and many other well-known studios and schools. He's a music teacher of distinction. He's a composer and a superb choreographer. His music and ballet videos can be viewed on YouTube, and if you like his music tonight, I urge you to go to YouTube and look at them. In March of this year, Stealth started to work with the CNIB, the Canadian National Institute for the Blind, connecting live musicians to visually disabled children in the hopes of inspiring them to love music and to play instruments. Stealth is an inspiring example of what our Prime Minister mentioned at the Invictus Games just this last weekend, namely that illness and injury can actually be a source of tremendous strength, and in Stealth's case, talent. So without further ado, a big hand please for Stealth Ng and his vintage 1920 Scarampella violin, Stealth.
Thank you so much, Dr. Trope. Hi, everyone. It's such a privilege and honor for me to be a part of such an incredible event tonight. This has been just an absolutely amazing evening for me to witness, not only because of the fabulous food and the good company, but mostly because of how inspiring it is to be in the same room with all of you who have made such an incredibly positive difference to the University Health Network. I feel so fortunate to be living in Toronto, to have access to good health care, outstanding treatment, phenomenal doctors and nurses, and amazing ophthalmologists. Looking back on when I was young, I took everything I had at the time for granted. I definitely took my ability to see well for granted. I was born with perfect eyesight, and my family never had any history of ocular conditions or vision loss. I grew up playing squash, taking taekwondo, swimming, music lessons, even the occasional ballet class, and had dreams of becoming a solo pianist or even a scientist. But all of that changed with my sudden cataract diagnosis when I was 12 years old. Quite suddenly, my perfect vision and aspirations slowly started to slip away from me. I couldn't read textbooks anymore or play any sports. Walking around at school and recognizing the faces of my friends became increasingly difficult as my visual acuity declined with every passing day, and attempting to read sheet music for music competitions became tearfully frustrating. Though I was fortunate enough to receive successful cataract treatment, my visual stability was short-lived. Just a year after those surgeries on both eyes, I had numerous complications with my intraocular lenses continuously dislocating. That in turn affected my retinas, which led to more than 6 retinal detachments in just 2 years, each time The recovery period was longer, more strenuous, and each time I wondered whether or not it would occur again. That was the very first time I stepped foot in Toronto Western Hospital, 10 years ago in 2007. What followed in the next decade were regular visits to the emergency room and back-to-back surgical procedures that completely reshaped all of my priorities. I remember spending 3 consecutive New Year's Eves at the Toronto Western ER because of retinal detachment symptoms, anxiously awaiting for an on-call ophthalmologist to tell me whether or not I had another complication in my eyes that would rob me of my vision again. Yet, the last of my retinal detachments saw another complication, trauma to my cornea, which resulted in a year-long wait for a suitable corneal transplant. Finally, when the donor graft arrived and the transplant procedure was successful, yet another retinal detachment resulted in a vitrectomy that in turn traumatized my successful corneal transplant and turned it into a failed graft, leading to corneal edema and glaucoma. Since then, my eyes and intraocular pressure have been closely monitored by Dr. Trope, including numerous procedures alone to lower my intraocular pressure. Throughout all of this, the uncertainty and fear of losing my vision, the worry my parents had every time I was admitted for surgery, the many sleepless nights I had wondering whether I would have to give up my career path and goals because my eyes got in the way, all of this has been the biggest wake-up call for me throughout my adolescent years. I guess you can say those surgeries were pretty eye-opening. But what I learned throughout all of this was how different it would be were it not for what exists at Toronto Western Hospital and the Donald K. Johnson Eye Institute, and for every single person who made sure I received the best treatment, the best care, and the best medication. Were it not for the receptionists that let me see my doctors at a last-minute notice, or the nurses and anesthesiologists who held my hand, reassured me that everything would be okay after my surgeries. Were it not for the patience of the surgeons who had just way too many people to see, too many surgeries to book in, or even the on-call fellow who came in at 3 a.m. to take my pressure and tend to an infected eye. Were it not for the actions of all those collective individuals alone, my faith and hope that I would recover would have never lasted. It is because of their care, their passion, their patience, their dedication, and even love that I still have eyesight today. And that remaining eyesight has allowed me to pursue my current career and dreams. The ability to see again has given me the chance to collaborate with other artists, to work with photographers and cinematographers, and to produce videos with ballerinas, dancers, and musicians. It has allowed me to work as a music teacher and as a ballet accompanist, to have an income and to do things that would require eyesight. It has allowed me to fall completely in love with ballet, for when I lost my eyesight and performed music, the same mental imagery that I envisioned while blind connected with the visualizations that dancers create to live music when I regained my vision. Losing my eyesight and regaining it has made me realize as well that I can inspire patients and children who are blind by bringing live music to them, that they have hope to become artists and musicians themselves, even if they cannot see. But most of all, losing my sight has given me a personal vision. A vision to make a difference in more than just my own life and career, and to extend my own abilities to make the world around all of us a happier, kinder place. A world where people are more positive, more grateful, and more hopeful for all that we can do and all that we can give and share with each other. And it is really a world that I hope will take example from all the good that has been and continues to be done by each and every one of you in this room tonight. So I'd again like to thank Dr. Trope for his absolutely phenomenal talent and care that he's given me over the years. As well as Christy Spencer and Rebecca Valenti, where are you guys? I can find you. I might not be able to see you, but you'll have to stand up. For arranging my attendance tonight. And finally, of course, to all of you whose support and giving has affected so much in my life, in the lives of my family, and I am certain in many others as well. For in another time and place, were it not for all of you, I would very much be blind today. Thank you so much. Actually a tango dance piece. It's called Por Una Cabeza by Carlos Garda. I'd love to share just one last musical number. I actually came across this musical competition a few weeks ago, and when I heard it, I just fell in love with it. And for the final piece, very appropriately titled, I'd like to share with you all Last Song by Alexis French.